Good morning, students. This is your math teacher Muhammad Irshad. This class I am recording for Sunday, 29th of March 2020, which will be your fifth class of math through this media lecture. Today we will do exercise 13.7, which is about volume of cone. So let's start our class. So cone, already you have learned about cone in exercise 13.7. A cone is a three-dimensional figure, three-dimensional geometrical shape that tapers smoothly from a flat base to a point called apex or vertex. And the three main properties, which I have already explained you in details in exercise 13.7, are that it has one circular face, it has zero edges, and it has one vertex or corner. Now we will derive the formula for the volume of cone. You have already learned about the cylinder. You are also familiar with the cone. So here, let us take a hollow cylinder and a hollow cone of same base radius r and same height h. And we will do one activity here. We have taken two hollow cylinder and one hollow cylinder and one hollow cone. So fill up this cone with some sands or any kinds of liquids and pour it in this cylinder, hollow cylinder. You will see some part of the cylinder will be filled. For the second time also do the same thing. Take the same liquids or sand in this hollow cone and pour it in the same cylinder. You will see here again some parts of the cylinder has been filled up and still some parts are empty. The same process we will repeat for the third time, and after doing for the third time you will see the cylinder has been filled up completely. So what we have observed here, when we have poured three times this cone's material in a cylinder, then it has been filled up completely. So we can say that the volume of a cone is 1/3 of the volume of cylinder. We know the volume of a cylinder is equals to pi r square h. This also we have done already in the previous exercises. So here we can say the volume of a cone will be equals to 1/3 of the volume of cylinder, that is pi r square h. Because when one time we are filling the materials of a hollow cone in hollow cylinder, then the part of cylinder which is filled up, that is 1/3 of the cylinder, means the volume of this cone given in this diagram, volume of this cone is equals to 1/3 of the volume of cylinder, what we have seen in the on previous slide in the activity also. So we can say volume of a cone is equals to 1/3 of the pi r square h. So this formula will be applicable in this exercise. So let's move to question number 1. Question number 1 is, find the volume of right circular cone with given radius 6 cm and height 7 cm. And second question also same, they have given the radius and height. Means radius and height is given, you have to find volume. So we will write the data given here. R is equals to 6 cm, H is equals to 7 cm. Therefore, the volume of cone is equals to, we all know, 1 by 3 pi r square h. Just put the value of this pi r and h. So 1 by 3, pi is equals to 22 by 7, r is square, and r is given here 6. So you can write 6 into 6, or you can write 6 square also. Later on you can break it into 6 into 6. 6 square means 6 into 6, 6 multiplied by 6, that is 36. And into this height is given here 7. Now you can reduce this, cut it, 3 1 times, 3 2 times, 7 1 times, here 7 1 times. And remaining all these number you can multiply, 1 multiply by 22, multiply by 6, multiply by 2, again multiply by 1, you will get this. So this you can solve by yourself, you can multiply it in your notebook, you will get your answer 264, and unit will be cube, centimeter cube or cubic centimeter, because this is a volume. In area I have told you, in area the unit will be square units, like square centimeter, square meter, whatever unit they will give, but square you have to keep it there. In same like that, in volume the unit will be cube unit. Means whatever will be the unit, if centimeter then centimeter cube, if meter then meter cube. So here the units they have given, they have used centimeter everywhere along with the height and radius, so our unit of volume will be centimeter cube. Similarly, number 2 also you can do in the same way, same formula, radius and height is given, you will put the formula and just substitute the value of pi, r and h. You will get here answer 154 centimeter cube. Now we will move to question number 2. Question number 2, find the capacity in liters of a conical vessel with radius 7 cm and slant height 25 cm. So here they have given radius and slant height. You can see in this figure, this is radius, this is slant height, this one. You have learned in exercise 13.3 also about this. So this slant height they have given. But for finding the capacity, capacity means volume, we need 1 by 3 pi r square h. So we need h. So for that we will find here h using that Pythagoras theorem. Here r is given, radius you can see in the figure, this one is given and this one is given, slant height l equals to 25, we will find this h. So in this right angle triangle, this h is a perpendicular here, and we all know perpendicular is equals to under root hypotenuse square minus this base square. So here hypotenuse is l and base is r. So we can write, therefore h is equals to under root l square minus r square, and l value is 25, so 25 square will be 625. And r is 7, so 7 square will be 49. When you subtract this, you will get 576, and the square root of 576 will be 24. This you can find it. Then you will find what they are asking. They are asking the capacity, that is the volume of conical flask. Sorry. So the volume of conical vessel. So volume of conical vessel is 1 by 3 pi r square h. So just put the value of pi, r and h here. So 1 by 3, pi is 22 by 7, it's constant value, and r is given 7. Here you can see radius is 7, so r is square, so 2 times you can write it, r into r, so 7 into 7, and h we got it from here, 24, so 24. Then you can cut this 3 and 7 here, then you can solve it, you will get this 1232 centimeter cube. And we want to convert this into liter, so just divide it by 1000. So this also I have explained you in details why dividing by 1000. So in the previous exercise 13.3, hope you all remember it. If you forgot, then you can see that video again. So whenever you want to divide some centimeter cubes into liter, just divide it by 1000. So divide by 1000, you will get here 30. So give decimal after 3 digit from the extreme right hand side. So here 1 digit, 2 digit, 3 digit, means here it will come after 2. So 1.232 liter will be the answer. Now move to question number 3. Sorry, 2 is also there, part 2 of question 2 is also there, so we will solve that also. In this case also they have said the same thing, find the capacity, but they have given here height and slant height. Radius they have not given, means they have given this slant height and this height. This height is 12 and this slant height is 13, L is 13. So you have to find this in a triangle. If you will see according to a right angle triangle, then this is called base. So base square is equals to under root hypotenuse square minus perpendicular square, and here hypotenuse is L and perpendicular is H. So you can just put the value of L and H, you will get R that is equals to 5. Here we have put the value 13 square 169, 12 square 144, so under root 25, which is equals to 5. So volume of conical flask is equals to 1 by 3 pi r square h. Now just put the value of pi r and h, we got this centimeter cube. Again we want the answer in liter, so just divide by 1000. This is the answer, just divide by 1000. When you will solve this, you will get 11 by 35 answer in a fraction, or if you will divide, you will get in decimal your answer. So decimal will be like here, you can see it's a proper fraction, so decimal, in decimal it will come less than 1, so keep it like this, in a fraction only, no problem. Now move to question 3. In question number 3, the question is, the height of a cone is 15 cm, its volume is given 1570 cm³. Find the radius of the base. Here you have to find radius. So height is given 15 cm, volume is given 1570 cm³, and we all know, since volume of a cone is equals to 1 by 3 pi r square h, just in place of volume put its value 1570, and that said 1 by 3, and then pi, they told you to use 3.14, so instead of pi we have put its value 3.14, then r square, and instead of h we will write 15 as it is given here. You can see the first line here. Now this is the unknown term we have to find. So first here you can cut this 15 by 3, 3 1 times, 3 5 times. So same thing, what you will get here, 3.14 multiplied by r square into 5. Now I need this r square, so keep the r square in left hand side, remaining these two in multiplication, so it will go here this side in division. So it came here down in a denominator position, and when you will solve this, you will get 100. So therefore r is equals to under root 100, under root 100 means 10. So you got here, you can say therefore we got the radius of the base is equals to 10 cm. Now let's move to question number 4. Question number 4, here also, if the volume of a right circular cone of height is 9 cm, is this much, means height they have given 9 cm, volume they have given 48 pi in terms of pi, no problem, centimeter cube. Find the diameter of the base, means we have to find first radius. So we know, since volume of a cone is equals to 1 by 3 pi r square h, just substitute the value, volume, instead of volume we will write this 48 pi is equals to that side 1 by 3 pi, then r square into h, h means given here 9, put it 9 here, then you can see we can cut this 9 by 3, 3 1 times, 3 3 times, this side pi and that side pi both can be cut. So now r square is equals to what, 48, and this 3 will go down here because it is in multiplication, so it will go in division that side. So 3, now 48 by 3 will give you 16, therefore r is equals to under root 16, that will give you 4, under root 16. Square root of 16 is 4, because 4 into 4 it gives you 16. Therefore the base diameter of the cone is equals to, here we got the radius, so base diameter will be twice of it, so just multiply by 2, so 2 into 4, that is equals to 8 cm. 5 is also same like this, so you can do by yourself. Question number 5, let's move to question number 6. 6 is having 3 parts. In question number 6, they are having 3 parts. The volume of a right circular cone is given 9856 cm³. If the diameter of base is 28 cm, find this height of the cone, slant height of the cone, and curved surface area of the cone. So actually this question should, it belongs to previous exercise 13.3 only. No problem, because it's a volume, in terms of volume, so they have given here, and nothing is new here. So you just start doing, write the given data, diameter they have given, so we can write radius, radius is equals to diameter by 2, that is 28 by 2 will give you 14 centimeter, and volume they have given 9856 centimeter cube. So volume of the cone is equals to 1 by 3 pi r square h, we all know. Now instead of volume, just put its value, that is 9856 is equals to that side given 1 by 3 pi value is 22 by 7 r they have, we have got here 14, so 14 into 14 because r square is there, so 2 times 14 into 14, and h we have to find. So keep height h same as it is. Now we have cut it here, so this is equals to what we got here, 1 by 3 here 22 into 14 into 2. So now h is equals to what we will get, what is here in numerator that will go that side denominator, what is here in denominator that will go in numerator that side. So h is equals to, we got this 9856 multiply by 3 because 3 is this side, in denominator it will go there up numerator, and this all 22 into 14 into 2 will go down in denominator position. Now you can solve it, this you can multiply or divide, you can do the calculation in your own way, then you will get 48, h is equals to 48. So this is the height of the cone, you can write, therefore the height of the cone is equals to 48 centimeter. And part 2 and part 3 we will do on next slides. Let's move to part 2 and 3. So in part 2 they told you to find the slant height. So what is given here? Now radius is same, given 14 centimeter, and height we have got from here question number 1, 48 centimeter. So now we can find it. So height we got this one, h we got this, r we got. Now we can find this slant height. If you will see this as a right angle triangle, then this is hypotenuse. So this L slant height, L hypotenuse is equals to under root perpendicular square plus base square, that is h square plus r square. H value is 48, so 48 square plus r value is 14, so 14 square. When you solve this, you will get this under root 2500. So the square root of 2500 is equals to 50. For 20 you will get 10, for 25 you will get 5. So you got here slant height of the cone is equals to 50 centimeter. And the third part they told you find the curved surface area of the cone, that already we have done in previous exercise. Curved surface area of cone you all know is equals to pi r l. Pi's value is 22 by 7, r is given 14, and l we got it here, you can see 50. So write 50, and its unit will be centimeter square because it's a area, surface area, curved surface area. Now you can cut this 14 by 7, 7 1 times, 7 2 times. Now this 2 multiply by 50 will give you 100, and 100 multiply this 22 will give you 2200. So 2200 or 2200 centimeter square will be the answer. Now we will move to question number 7. Let's move to question number 7. Question number 7, a right triangle ABC, you can see in the figure, right triangle ABC here, this one, see, I am trying to point you by a pointer, the right angle triangle A, B and C, right angle is at B. Right angle triangle with side 5 cm, 12 cm and 13 cm. So first put this dimension on the given diagram. Triangle is ABC, you know the longest side will be always hypotenuse, so in hypotenuse I have given 13, and the other two side you can put anywhere, no problem, one should be base, one should be height. So here in place of height I have given 12, in place of base I have given 5. You can see this much only, this part only, what I am tracing with a pointer, ABC is a right angle triangle. Now this triangle is revolved about the side 12 centimeter. So this side is 12 centimeter, along this it is revolving. So it will revolve like this. See my pointer, it will revolve like this. Find the volume of the solid obtained. So what solid will obtain like this? This conical solid will obtain. This one, because this triangle revolving like this around this axis AB, same like you are seeing the earth is rotating in its axis. So you will get this solid, this cone shaped solid AACC'. So it's just a cone. They have twisted the question little bit. So here in this case you can see your height is 12 centimeter, base radius is 5 centimeter. Now you need to find the volume of the solid. So the volume of the cone, that means the volume of cone you all know, 1 by 3 pi r square h. Just put the value of pi r and h. Pi is same like that, pi you can put it because pi you can keep it like this only, or you can put its value also, because this question number 7 actually is related to question 8 also. So here I have put in terms of pi only. You will see why we can put here pi. When we will read the question 7, then you will come to know. So 1 by 3 pi, r value is 5, so 5 into 5 2 times, because r square, and h is 12, so 12 here. Now you can solve it. This 3 can cut this 12, 3 can cut this 3 1 times, 3 4 times. So now 5 5 25 into 4 will give you 100, and this pi will be same like this. So your answer will be the volume of the cone will be 100 pi centimeter cube. Or if you want to put the value of pi, you can put it, no problem. You can put it 3.14 pi value. When you will multiply this, answer will be 314 centimeter cube. 314, because here 20 are here, so these two decimal will be shifted to right hand side. So 314 centimeter cube, or you can keep it like this also, no problem. Marks will be not deducted for all these things. Hope it is clear to you all. Now question number 8 is related to this question only. So let's move to question number 8 and see what they are asking. See this diagram properly. In this diagram I told you this triangle is revolving along the side AB, along its height of the side 12 centimeter. Now let's move to question number 8. Question 8. If the triangle ABC in question 7, means the previous question above, is revolved about the side 5 centimeter, then find the volume of the solid so obtained. Find also the ratio of the volume of two solids obtained in question 7 and 8. So hope now your idea is clear about the previous question and this question. What is the relation between these two questions? Actually both questions are same. In that previous question number 7, they told you the diagram, the triangle was revolving revolving around the height 12 centimeter. Here it will revolve around the side 5 centimeter. Suppose this was your triangle, right angle triangle A B and C, same like before. A, B and C, this is same triangle. There also AB was your height 12 centimeter, BC was 5 centimeter, and this one 13 centimeter. But here this, it will not revolve like this. It will revolve here like this. See my pointer, it will revolve like this along this side, along the side of 5 centimeter. So it will start revolving like this. It will start revolving like this. You can see I'm trying to show by the pointer. So hope it is clear to you all now. So in this case your base is this one AA dash. So radius will be this 12 centimeter, base radius will be AB 12 centimeter, which was there in the previous case height. Here the same height will become radius here. So here I have written here R means radius of the cone is equals to 12 centimeter. This one is the radius, and this will be the height BC. So, and height of the cone will be 5 centimeter. This is the only difference that you have to understand here. Remaining things are same in both questions. Now again you have to find the volume of the cone. So volume formula is same, 1 by 3 pi r square h, and just 1 by 3 pi, and r is here 12, so 12 into 12, and h is 5. When you will solve this, you will get 240 pi centimeter cube. This can, or you can put the value of pi also. Now in second case, they told you find the ratio of the volumes of the two solids in question 7 and 8. So the required ratio of the volumes of two solids in case of question 7 and 8 is equals to, so question number 7 was 100 pi and question number 8 we got 240 pi. This is the volume of, you can see this 100 pi was the volume of question 7, and here 240 pi is the volume of question number 8 here we got. So find the ratio. So pi and pi cut, then with the blue color you can see I have cut 10 from numerator and 1 for denominator. Then here left 10 and down left 24, so you can cut it by 2, 5 times and 12 times. So answer will be 5 by 12, or you can write it in the ratio format like 5 is to 12. So the ratio of the two solids obtained in question 7 and 8 is equals to 5 is to 12. So hope the and question number 9, after this question number 9, it is same to find the volume only. It's about a heap of a wheat in the form of cone whose diameter is 10.5 and height is given 3 meter. Find its volume and then also find the canvas area of canvas required to protect it from rain. So it's about, you know, volume only. They have given height and they have given diameter, so you can get the radius and then you will find the volume. And second part they told you find the area of canvas, so for that you will find first lateral height L you will find, and then you will find the covered surface area, that is pi RL. So it is the same question, nothing new, so you can do question number 9 as homework. So hope that today's class was also clear and helpful for you all. So just watch the video again and again and keep makes your confusion clear. Hope you all are practicing at your home. So stay at home. Be safe. Have a good day. Thank you.